style runs deep. On Women of Style today, we have a lady whose sartorial wisdom runs deep. She has an appreciation and understanding when it comes to fashion, an eye for detail, and her heart is in the right place. Not only is she an amazing but incredibly talented human being, she's a model, she's a fashion influencer, she's a champion for independent designers, and she's one of the most powerful fashion voices in Southeast Asia, Kim Jones-Rosales. What up? I like the sachet down the stairs. Thank you for letting us come into your home. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
Your house is gorgeous.
Thank you.
Very gorgeous. I actually feel like I'm walking like in a like an art space.
It was Echo and his best friend who designed the house, and I love it. So it existed when we got married and I came in. It was obviously resembled much more of a bachelor pad than anything else, and I wanted to lighten it up, I wanted to soften it up. I love art, and it's something that I want to put more of in the space. I wanted something that was a blank canvas because my style is always changing. I can't stay in one space too long, so I wanted something that was flexible enough that I could just kind of throw together one month and then, you know, a year later change it up again.
What is the frequency that you just enjoy being in most of the time?
Well, I am much more of an introvert. I'm an introvert extrovert. You know, if I'm in a social setting, you know, I'm very, very open, I'm very energetic, but then it takes me a couple of days to sort of recover from that. Like, I do kind of need my personal space. I need to be on my own. I need to read. I need to be with my dog, Atticus. So I wanted a space where it felt like a little bit of an escape, because when I travel so much, you know, it's kind of like that, like it's like I travel so much, but it's for work. So when I come back, that's when I get to relax. That's when I get to switch off.
Obviously, there is more of you in your humble abode.
Yes.
And was hubby down with that? He's cool with it?
I don't think he really had a choice. I mean, do they ever?
Oh, good wife.
Yeah, right, exactly. It's all about balance, give and take.
Which brings me, how'd you guys get together?
We met through a friend who was a makeup artist, and I was 3 months new into the Philippines, and she, I guess, it was a setup.
I love it. It was a setup. Fresh off the boat.
Yeah, fresh off the boat. Yeah. She just suggested that I meet this young man, and I, you know, was all for it. I had no friends, so I was like, let's do it. After that, we didn't really speak for 2 months. But then he invited me to La Union to surf. And so he taught me how to surf. So when he did that, I was like, sige, puede na. I was like,
puede na. Yeah.
And then it was his love. Just, he's such a beautiful heart, and he's such an honest and generous and genuine person that it's hard not to fall in love with him.
And that's the story.
And that's the story.
Surf
and then marriage happened.
And
yes. And we've been married for 4 years on May 1. We got married on Labor Day.
While there's a lot of interest in Kim and Echo's love story and marriage, I wanted to know more about Kim and how she found her voice in the realm of fashion and feminism, so to speak. Before we go forward, I need to go backwards.
Okay.
So I want to get to when you were making your mind up on you're going to come over to the Philippines.
Yes.
You are half Filipina, half British. Which part is who?
So my dad is British and my mother is Filipino, Spanish, Chinese. So I was born in the UK and then my family migrated to Australia when I was 2. So we spent some time in Sydney and I grew up in a very, very small city before moving finally to another city in South Australia.
Growing up in a small town, did that engage your interest for larger cities and noise then?
Yeah,
right?
I think the
interest to come over here to Manila where it's kind of crazy.
I was moving around jobs. I dropped out of college. I was studying interior architecture. I dropped out and then I decided I wanted to go into finance and I wanted to work my way up. And I had two options. I could have gone back to the UK, which would have been easy for me, or I could have come to the Philippines. And I wanted a culture shock. The London and the UK felt too close to home. So I wanted something that would really jar me and challenge me. I was 23-year-old. Yeah. I had spent too long, I think, just knowing what the rest of my life looked like, and that terrified me.
I love that. I was wondering, how did your family think about this decision you wanted?
My brother, he was really the catalyst. He really provided the way for me to get here. My mom was like, are you kidding? So even to this day, she's sort of like, yeah, but I just don't understand what you do. Like, what do you do? But she's very happy for me now, and they've been very supportive. But it was It was hard work. It was hard work.
Do you have a memory of one of those hard knock moments of like, oh my God, but you're grateful for it now?
I don't know if there was any one moment, because I do really feel like you are essentially a byproduct of these micro moments, you know, these little decisions. Life is not made up of crossroads. They're not made up of big decisions. They're made up of these little ones. And I remember having 100 pesos to my name, and that was jarring. That was such a, you know, an eye-opener for me, because I sold everything in Australia. I broke up with my boyfriend at the time, so it was risky. I don't have family here. You know, I have some extended relatives, and then, you know, having to go to the castings, and you're not treated well as a model.
No, it's not a glamorous life.
On the table. Nope. Of,
everyone yeah. for themselves.
Yes, but it was amazing because it taught me so much about the hustle, and it's something I try to even sort of teach my own team.
You appreciate
yes.
that. It's humbling.
Yeah.
And then
yeah.
you always incorporate that wherever you go.
Yes.
When we come back, we will talk more about Kim Jones-Rosales as being a digital creative.